When Grace Lee Boggs was young, if she cried, the waiters at her father's restaurant would say, "Leave her on the hillside to die. She's only a girl." Grace later wrote in her autobiography that this gave her an inkling that all is not right with this world. Grace, who is Chinese American, earned an advanced degree in philosophy in 1940, but couldn't get a job because universities wouldn't hire Asians to be professors. Grace became an author, speaker, and lifelong activist for social justice. When World War II began, African Americans threatened to march on Washington to demand jobs in the factories. This forced President Franklin Roosevelt to issue an order to end racial discrimination in the defense industry. Grace explained that this showed the power that the black community has within itself to change this country when it begins to move. As a result, I decided to become a movement activist in the black community. Grace took part in the struggles for tenants' rights and joined the Workers' Party in 1940. She worked with the Trinidadian socialist C.L.R. James to develop ideas around black freedom and socialism. Grace thought that workers should run society for themselves. She wrote many articles encouraging workers to run their workplaces without owners. Grace moved to Detroit in 1952. There she became involved in civil rights and labor struggles. She married black revolutionary auto worker James Boggs in 1953. With local preachers and Dr. Martin Luther King, they helped organize a march of more than 250,000 people. They also built a conference with the black revolutionary Malcolm X. Malcolm X often stayed at their house when he spoke in Detroit. Together, they trained others who had become leaders in the Dodge Revolutionary Union Movement and the League of Revolutionary Black Workers. These groups fought against racist abuse and for equal pay and job opportunities in the Detroit auto plants. In 1967, racial tensions erupted in Detroit. While some called this a riot, Grace called it a rebellion against the racism people faced every day. But this rebellion and other uprisings at the end of the 1960s caused Grace to rethink her ideas about revolution. She still saw capitalism as the problem, but she also began to focus on how you cannot change any society unless you take responsibility for it, unless you see yourself as belonging to it and responsible for changing it. She also helped to start the Beloved Communities Initiative and programs like Detroit Summer. Focusing on rebuilding Detroit from the ground up, Grace and her fellow activists renovate houses, plant community gardens in vacant lots, and create community murals. To this day, Grace continues to write and remains active in Detroit.